What's going on, you guys? Yes, I am in here for another mukbang. It is morning time, so a little bit different. But I was like, you know, I'm eating my breakfast. It's the weekend. Usually they're going to be done on the weekend because that's when I'm not strict on what I eat. Not crazy either, but yeah, it's not eating granola and oats and yogurt for you to, you know. Anyway, yeah, it's a good angle. Usually my thing, my go-to, I'm a waffle girl. And my favorite brand, I love Eggos. And the strawberry ones are my favorite. Oh, my God. Yeah, I eat my breakfast with my hands. I'm in my house. Do the hell I want to do. Boom, got that Aunt Jemima light on deck. Yes, I do light. Whatever. I'm not a person that to lay out. I don't like laying out the waffles all over. Because I don't want my syrup touching my sausage. I'm not one of them type of people. Ain't nothing wrong with y'all. I'm just saying. I just like to put it on each waffle. Yes, they have their own. I mean, as I eat it, it may drizzle, but I don't want it all in my plate, you know. And I don't want to drown the waffle in syrup either because it's strawberry already. Artificial or not, it's strawberry. Whatever. And the turkey links, y'all. But I'm glad y'all are enjoying these, and it's a water. Sometimes I drink straight water. Sometimes it's, you know, it's like this, straight water. Is that gay water? No, I'm just saying. Sometimes it got a little bit of a flavor in it. But I drink water majority, 90% of the time. Your kidneys will say thank you. Your urine will be clear. Hey, praise the Lord. Ha! Anyway, so we got 3 strawberry waffles, Lego my Eggo, and... Who's the yellow box? That's not Jimmy Dean. I forgot the yellow box is. But I'll put it down in the description. So I want to thank, hey, y'all asking questions now. So I'm going to answer your question first, and then we're going to, you know, get into the other stuff. What's going on, Miss Stephanie? The sausage. I do them in the microwave. I damp the tissue a little bit, wrap it, and... It says 1 minute on the box. I put in for 2. I'm like, you're going to cook. I'm just saying. What's your question? How do you manage multiple channels, hold down a full-time job, and able to have fun with your friends? Great question. I ain't going to lie to you. 2 channels is work. It's work, but I don't see it as work. I enjoy this. And that's something I tell people. If you're going to get into YouTube, if you're just saying, oh, I want to get and make a quick buck, be YouTube famous, blah, 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 don't do it. Do it because it's something that you enjoy. Well, some people do it for business reasons, you know, to help their other businesses. But this is a hobby for me, which I get to utilize my talent, you know, videography mostly because that's what I'm doing, videos and editing. To get better at those things. I don't have a schedule per se. I have a camera with me all the time. So I'm filming all the time. It's just like, but now you see it at my banner. 1 video, I promise, I'll make sure I have 1 video a week. Usually more, but 1 video a week. And I don't say a certain day because, as you said, I got a full-time job. Look, and I don't want to be the type of people say, okay, Wednesday, and then I fall short of Wednesday, and I got to change my banner again. To some, I got time for that. So... Yeah, I have a camera all the time. Editing to me is like second nature. I love it. So it's real simple for me. You know, yeah, I think that covers the whole question. I find a balance. I mean, being an editing is easy for me and I could do it quickly. See, I tell you, it starts to drip, so I don't need to put a whole bunch. Yeah, okay. Come on. Yeah. Being that editing is, I have a certain style. You watch different people that videos, they have a certain style. So I know how long it's going to take me to edit something. I film exactly what I want, maybe a little bit more sometimes, but I film exactly what I want because I know, oh yeah, this is how I want this vlog to look. And, yeah. Editing is one of my downtime things when I'm watching TV, when I come home to even finish doing what I'm doing if I'm watching TV. I'm editing at the same time. So, yeah. And you have to make time for life. Even though, and I incorporate, I mean, vlogging, I'm sharing with you, is my life. You know, sometimes I've thought like, oh, I don't do nothing excited. What am I for? What are you doing? Stop it. You know, you have different vloggers that travel. I'm not doing all that. I'm here to share my everyday regular life. And yeah, two different parts. I go places and stuff, but I have a full-time job. So no, I'm not about to go for jump out of planes and stuff just to make y'all entertain. Y'all go do it. Film it. Let me see. Yeah. So thank you for that question, Stephanie. What's going on, Katrina Forever? Ha, this is interesting. Girl. I hate when you drink something and you squeeze it and it's at the top, so you don't want the water to squirt out. Yeah. I'm a morning person, so have you ever tried online dating? Yes, I have. Well, yeah, because, now I'm thinking of two different ways. Like, you know, you put your book. Yeah, I've tried online dating. And people may have their qualms like, oh my God, you do that. It's just another avenue, like you go to the bar, like you go to church. Stop it, you know, yeah. Parties, a recommendation to a friend, it's the same thing. It's just another avenue for you to meet people. And just the same way as you weeding out the dumbasses in that you may have met face to face, walking down the street, blah, blah, blah. It's the same shit like online. You know, people, you may say, oh, but people catfish you. People catfish you in front of your face. So it's like, it's the same shit. And I've had this discussion before. People may die. No, it's the same shit. It's just another avenue. It's the same shit. And the reason why I can say it, because I'm a regular human being. I utilize it, you know. It's just another avenue for to meet people. And you got to, again, you're dealing with the same. You just met them in a different place. Call these dating apps. Call them clubs. POF club. Match.com club. Same shit. DVS, how was your experience? Currently, the person I'm dating, I met off one of them. Again, it's just another avenue. You know what I'm saying? And then you got to put into work to see if you're going to deal with this person or not. I don't put nothing. You meet somebody, offer them. Who cares? As long as what's going on, as long as it's, you know, whatever's going on is serving you, you happy, blah, blah, blah. If you're not happy, get out of it, blah, blah. So I ain't here to judge nobody. Do what you got to do. If no, would you consider it? Okay, well, I answered that question. You know, for those of you who don't know, in this lesbian community, there are different categories. It's hard for women such as myself to meet other lesbian women. You may all know. Because, well, it also depends on the type of woman you like. Because, you know, you have stud for stud. That's women. God, I hate these names. Women that look like me who like women that look like me. I ain't got nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with it. But I don't really like the labels. But they're there for, whatever. But when dealing with how my preference is feminine women. Break it down. I like femme-aggressive women. It's hard to be on the street and just approach someone that you think that's gay. I'm not trying to die because I'm gay. For extra reasons, because I'm trying to talk to somebody. It's hard to know if these feminine females are gay. Yeah, some, you know, people look at me and some, but they could be, I don't know what reason they're looking at me for, so I'm not about to die because I'm trying to holler. And then, you know, but then you have those that are out right there wearing flags and rubber. I'm good. That ain't for me. That ain't for me. You're doing a bit too much. Like, there's one, this one chick hit me up on, on one of these sites. Ain't no trying to kick it. And they was asking me questions. Now, mind you, I'm 42. I think she was a few years older than me. And she was like, one of the questions she asked me, and I was like, okay, bye, bye, bye. Do you have a problem with women who, wear the rainbow this and I got rainbow beat? Bye, bye, bye. That shit to me, that's for Gay Pride Day. And if you know, for those babies that just came out, not even out in today, back in my day, there's all this rainbow shit. Look, you gay, you gay. You know you're gay. You don't got it. It's just too much. And it's just not for me. I'm walking down the street with you, say you my boom. People already assume, oh, you gay because they look at me. I don't need the extra attention. And they ask me, I don't like extra attention. I don't like it. That's why I won't, you know, deal with women. Don't have no bright ass colors in your hair. I don't like it. First of all, you black. Why is your hair colors that naturally black people don't get? I'm just saying, I don't like extra attention. Oh, let's get into some would you rathers. It's the first time I'm opening this app. Classic mode. Why don't... Oh. It says... It gives me two choices. Okay, play. But this is adult stuff. I'm sorry. It's either or. Having sexual impotence for the rest of your life. Or... This is would you rather only having sex with transsexuals. First of all, a woman can't get impotence. I don't have a penis. But what's the equivalent to impotence? You can't get it up. It can't get wet. Oh damn, that's what they call that? Dryness. All right, so for women, okay. Having sexual is there a name for it, ladies? I don't know. Put it down below. So having sexual dryness for the rest of your life, or only having sex with transsexual? I'm gonna take the transsexual. Yes, I am. Transsexual, but which way? Which way though? It gotta be fine. It's book. I'm just saying. Next, either or, I would have sex with a coworker. I would not have sex with a coworker. I would not. Is this yes or no, or would you rather? Hold on, let me come out of this, because I'm like, what am I in? Because, yes, would you rather? So, would you rather heterosexual, but you will like to try same-sex gender? 100, okay, skip this, because I'm gay. Bye. Would you rather get married? Don't get married or get married. Either or is fine. I mean, get married, but, yeah, if it happens, it happens. It doesn't, it doesn't. Would you rather, have you ever sneak out of someone's bed before, or you haven't had the necessity to sneak out of someone's bed, haven't had the necessity? Excuse me. Oh. Would you rather catch your grandmother masturbating or not being able to masturbate for 6 months? Not being able to masturbate for 6 months, because you could do other things. It says masturbate. How you doing? Would you rather die because of having too much sex or dying a virgin? I'll die happy, so I'll die because of having too much sex. Now don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with being a virgin. Honey, save yourself if that's what you're doing. Whatever, but I'm just saying. It's my question. I told you this is adult. My thing is, I mean, looking at my analytics, grown people watch me, so we good. Would you rather, it says missionario, but that's supposed to be missionary. I don't know if you can see that. Missionario or doggy style. Doggy style. Would you rather having the person you love fall in love with you? Or having the job of your life? Why is this an either or? I'd rather both, but sick of the question. Oh, I read that wrong. Having the person you love fall in love with you. Okay. And then, or having the job of your life. I do the job of my life. Yeah. Do you like deep voices or high pitched voices? Well, in my experience, high pitched voices. Would you rather breathing your last breath with your family or breathing your last breath with your love of your life? My thing is, combine this together, because, I mean, the love of my life, that would be family as well, so, yeah. Could you stop your whimpering? Because I did put your food down, and if you had eaten some of it, I'd give you a piece of sausage, but we're not about that life. I'm about to go to a different app. Now, this one is called Yes or No Adults. It's my first time loading. Okay, I agree. What's this? Okay, not now. Bye. Okay, well, I do press play. Do you like driving fast? In certain situations, yeah. Sandy, could you stop, please? What? Okay, this is whack. I'm about to get rid of that app. It's whack. Some stupid ass. We're going back to Would You Rather. Would you rather have no social life or have no sex? Breakfast almost done. All right. I have no social life. 68% have no social life. All right. Sandy, stop it.
With this federal government.
Okay, commercials. Would you rather have the best education or have the best girlfriend or boyfriend? What is the best education? What money can buy? What is the best education? I think that's up to everybody's interpretation. To some people, their GED is their best education. To some people, like, oh, but you ain't not them. But you can't judge somebody else's journey. Somebody, you know, if you don't go to Harvard, or what's another one? Best education. I'm gonna take it. That's everybody's interpretation. I'm gonna go have the best girlfriend. Yeah. Let me see what people say. Yeah, 55% best girlfriend or boyfriend, 45% best education. Ta-da! Oh. All right, we're going to close on this note because I'm going to talk. I want to talk about this. Would you rather have 5 friends with benefits or have one stable relationship? One stable relationship. Look, we touched on this in one other mukbang before. There was a question about that. Friends with benefits is fuckery. You can go ahead and believe that shit because, you know, that's your dream. That's your imagination. That's your reality, your truth. That's bullshit. First of all, friends do not have sex. They don't have sex. Friends do not. If you my friend, there in that there are boundaries and there are boundaries. There's you have boundaries in friendship. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. People want to say no. Yes, you do. There's certain things you do and certain things you don't. Having sex is one of them things you don't. Once you have that intimacy, you ain't friends no more. That's some other shit. You a side chick. You what you call that? You a fuck buddy. You're not a friend. And people, somebody gonna catch feelings. Y'all can lie to me. Have your friends been say, and none of y'all catch feelings. That again, you live in that fairy tale. No friends with benefits. No, this y'all want to call it that to make. Okay, after that, you know, say you had this, you have sex, and it's awkward. What do you do after that? What the fuck are we talking about? Why am I in your privates? Why are you in my privates? You're my friend. Nah, bro. This one's too long. I got soggy. Nah. Nah. Anyway, guys. Thank y'all for having breakfast with me. I'm drinking Clear Choice. This is the kiwi strawberry. All right, fuck that. Friends with benefits. What the hell is that shit, bro? It's bullshit. It's bullshit. Another thing I want to talk about, too. I think someone made a comment to that. Friends with benefits, like, oh, something about less money spent. Some shit like that. I mean, is that what people you resort to? Is like the value of what we are. I mean, I get it. You know, nobody wants to waste their time and stuff. But I don't know. I just can't attribute relationship to finance. Granted, nah, I ain't trying to splurge out on something. But I don't know. That's just not the first thought in my mind. So I'm going to have a friends with benefits. So I don't got to spend money on somebody. So I don't gotta build something meaningful. I'm sorry. I'm not here for it. I'm 42. I don't have time for the bullshit. Fuck out of here. You're my friend, that's the benefit. I'm your friend, that's the benefit. We have sex, we ain't friends no more. And that's my reality. Yours may be different, it's okay. That's what makes the world go round, right? And I'm out.